power formula. And again, 6 to 8 minutes.
Thank you. By now, everyone in this room should have already decided whether or not they're going to be listening to my speech. It's called the 8 seconds rule. 8 seconds is all it takes for the audience to decide whether the speaker is worth listening to. This is according to a book that I've been reading. It's called The New Articulated Executive. And this book talks about how to be a better speaker and a better presenter. And it's a great book. I encourage you all to read it. But first, let me share with you 5 points from this book that the author calls the power formula. The first point is the P, and the P stands for punch. And just like I demonstrated, the punch is that strong introduction that you need in your speech. You need to build some anticipation. You need to make your audience want to hear what you have to say. So try to forget the traditional approach where people come up and say thank you to the audience and they start with, this is what I'm going to be talking. Don't say, this is what I'm going to be talking about. Just say, just start with your main point. Or for example, you can start with a question or start with a personal story that you can tie back to your main point. The second point in the power is the O. The O here stands for one theme. Just like the name suggests, one theme is you try to keep all your points under the same umbrella. If you have to, for example, if you have to talk about how to time your, how to manage your time better, and then you have to switch gears to how to dress for success, try to keep them all under how to be a better person, more successful person. If you keep all your points under the same subject, your speech will flow much better. It will be more coherent. And your audience will remember you better. So if you have many points that you have to talk about, try to keep them all on the same subject or just dedicate different speeches for them. The third point is W. W here stands for windows. What the author calls windows is examples and illustrations. You need examples for two things. One, if you're given a speech and your audience doesn't know what you're talking about, maybe they're from a different background, or you're introducing a new concept, for example, you probably want to give them an example that will drive the point home. Two, if you're talking about a point, introducing a concept, you can give an example that will probably give proof or credibility. Take, for instance, a business meeting, and you're around the table, and you tell them, we had a great year this year. That means nothing until you show them some numbers, you give them some charts to actually back up your claim. So the next point is going to be ear. And ear here stands for, or means conversational speech. The author claims that you should always try to keep your speech conversational. Use simple English, and it's proven to be just as effective as speeches that are loaded with buzzwords. So, in fact, if you look, you'll see that most of the deals are being cut on golf courses, not round tables with people in suits and conference rooms. Let me give you actually another example. Does anyone drive a Jeep here? No? Well, Jeep is one of the most iconic cars in the U.S. And back in 2008, in the recession, the Jeep CEO, the Chrysler, which is part of Jeep as well, he was in big trouble, and the company needed money to be bailed out, and he was in front of Congress to give him a speech. They were expecting him to give a 4-hour speech about why they should give him money. Well, he walked into the room and he said this, "Ladies and gentlemen, the situation is simple. We have 100,000 people who are about to go out of job. You will be cutting them a check. It's called welfare. Or you can give me that money. Now put them back to work, and we'll get this company back on its feet, and then we'll make American economy better in the process." And then the CEO walked out with a check, and the U.S. now keeps producing Jeeps every day. My last point, and not least, is the R. The R stands for retention. Retention here is for the conclusion. Every speech, just like a strong introduction, needs a strong conclusion as well. As you're building your speech in the body with great momentum, you should keep that momentum going in the conclusion as well. So when your audience leaves, they leave with the point that they remember. So not only they understand your point, but they also remember that with a strong conclusion. It's like crescendo, that you end at a high note. For example, if you want to give a good conclusion, you can always summarize the main points and the main body of the speech, but you can also end it with a personal story as well, or you can end it with a question, just give them some food for thought, or you can call for action, which is what I'm going to do in my conclusion. I invite you all, and Jessica on Friday, try to incorporate these five points that I talked about today in your next speech, and hopefully that will help you make your speech more powerful. Thank you.